What's going on, family? Welcome back to another video. I know it's been a minute, but I've been catching up on so many different things. I have so much to update you guys with. But right now, my boy from the East Coast of Canada is here on the West Coast visiting me right now. And I actually trained him too. He's a part of the Team Lifts crew. So I'm about to pick him up and we're about to get a lift in. By the title of the video, you guys already know what's up. So I wanna go over that, but first I wanna go over a couple things and we gotta meet up with my boy Nick. So sit back, relax, and let's get this video started.
Are you always in the mood? Fuck around like I'm brand new. I ain't trying to tell you what to do, but try to play cool. Baby, I ain't playing by your rules. Everything look better with a view.
What's up, bro?
What's up, man?
Ready to get this lifted?
Oh my god, super excited, dude.
Let's get it,
super
man.
Super excited, man.
So it's almost like perfect timing that I wore my athlete shirt today, because what is going on? But I need to hook my boy up with some gear for coming down. I appreciate it.
We got the Team Lifts tee.
Love it.
Part of the squad.
Let's try this
and
on.
This one here too, bro.
Oh, nice, bro.
Yeah. All right, you guys know what time it is. About to take that Ghost pre-workout. So today I'm gonna be taking that pump stuff. You know, I have to be hooking up Nick with it.
Need some of that,
get that pump, right? So I think we're gonna be hitting a push workout for myself. We got lemon lime, we're gonna do 2 scoops of this. So I'm not always trying to take caffeine every single day. I'm trying to cut back, so I was getting too extreme with it. I feel like I was almost addicted to it. So this is a really good pre-workout. If you still want energy, you wanna get a pump, and you're not gonna get the negative side effects of taking caffeine all the time. So if you guys want this stuff, you guys can go in the description, code Patty for 20% off. But other than that, let's get into the workout.
Yo. No, Nick, that's a girl's bathroom.
Nick, he didn't have a bottle, so he domed it. And the,
oh my God,
the stuff is a little sour. He's not used to it.
He's gonna pump on.
All right, so I'm about to hit bench here. I got 3 plates on, and it's gonna be day one of my new Mesocycle. But as you guys know, shows were canceled. I got an email, or actually one of my clients got an email that said the hotel venue was closed or canceled from the WMBF World Show. And that was my main show of the year. So I believe that is shut down. I emailed them, I didn't get an email back on some questions, and I don't know if I can get over the border. So with all that said, I'm gonna maintain for the next couple weeks to see if anything changes. But for now, I think I probably won't be competing, you know, just to be safe. I don't even know if I can get over the border, and I don't even know if the shows are gonna be going on. So it's unfortunate, but I do wanna touch on this a little bit later, because I do feel like there's a silver lining to this. I feel like you guys should be able to connect with that as well. But since I'm gonna be transitioning from a maintenance to a bulking phase, I know a lot of you guys have a hard time actually bulking, because you start to gain fat too fast, you finish your cut, and then you bounce back really quickly. So throughout this workout, I wanna give you guys 3 tips to help you guys bulk without getting too fat too fast. Alright guys, so the first tip so you guys don't get too fat during your bulk is do not cheat and continue to cheat once you transition from a cut to a bulk. I know so many times you go into a cut, you start bulking, and then you start eating too much too fast, or you have a cheat day and that cheat day turns into a cheat week and you realize you lost out on so much of your progress within the first week already. So with that said, guys, the diet doesn't end when you start bulking. You know, you might want to have a refeed, have a cheat day to celebrate your success, but you still have to keep it decently tight and still have structure once you get into the bulk. I felt a little rough, but I'm gonna get it down.
Do you like chicken or turkey better?
I like that booty. So now that you guys have structure in place, the next thing you have to control is the rate of gain per week. And to more specifically measure this, a great recommendation is 1% gain per 1 month. Because if you gain too fast, you guys are gonna be just gaining fat. But if you don't gain weight fast enough, you won't be making any progress. So that 1% a month is a great rate to know you're in that sweet spot. So if you weigh 200 pounds, you guys would want to gain 2 pounds per month. And that's only 0.5 pounds per week if you're 200 pounds. So if you weigh less than this, your rate of gain should actually be slower than that. That's where a lot of people make the mistake. They start bulking and it's a couple months down the line and they realize, they're like, damn, I gained way too much weight too fast. I'm gonna have to start cutting again, and they get into that yo-yo cycle. But if you do gain at this rate and you're in that sweet spot, you're gonna be able to extend your bulk and stay leaner throughout the entire bulking process. And you're gonna have to shorten the amount of time you have to cut. So then you have more time to bulk, and then you won't have to cut as long. So I hope that makes sense. I'm gonna smash some machine flies and I'll give you guys tip number 3 and we'll finish off this workout. All right, guys, so the last tip I'm gonna give you is don't get bored with the plan. So once you start bulking, you're gonna go out, you're gonna get loose with things, you're probably just gonna go in the gym, try and destroy yourself. But you have to be as structured with the bulk as you are with the cut. So one really good tip you're gonna do to not get bored is to change up your workouts every month. And the last thing you're gonna do, last little side note I'm gonna recommend, is try to avoid lifestyle triggers. Just like when you're cutting, you can't be going and putting yourself in situations where you know you're gonna binge, you know? If you like to drink and you know when you start drinking you're gonna have a bunch of drinks that night, then maybe you should avoid that situation. Or if you know you're gonna go to your favorite restaurant where you're gonna wanna just go all in, then maybe choose a different restaurant you go to where you still can control the amount of food that you're intaking. So, other than that, guys, hope you guys enjoyed these tips. I wanna go over a little bit more detail. I want to go over more details of my prep plans and show you guys about the newest launch about to drop. I took the t-shirt off, but I'm excited about that. So finish this up. See you guys in a minute.
Patrick is a poop butt.
So we just finished that workout. I'm actually shooting on my new camera right now. This is the A6400. The A7 III is so big that it's hard to vlog with, and I wanna provide the least amount of friction possible to vlog since I'm not as consistent. And I ended up getting these, actually this whole outfit is Alphalete, but this side bag that I can just throw this camera in there and then I can vlog a lot easier. And I think Luna missed the... Hey, puppy, puppy! Hey! So for right now, post-workout, I usually just take 2 scoops of protein. It's a really fast and easy way to get protein in. And right now I'm smashing the Nutter Butter flavor. Literally tastes like the cookies. So if you're all about the flavor, Ghost definitely has your back. But I do want to go over my prep plan here in a minute and go over a new launch. So I was actually wearing my athlete tee earlier in the video, but I'll have those launching with my new Team Lifts tees and these hats, Limitless Collection 2 hats, which are really cool, and I'll show you guys those in a little bit here. So I'm keeping it real right now. Hannah and I passed out after she made me some shrimp and scallops. Super macro friendly, guys, if you're looking for something good to eat and switch up your protein sources. We're about to hit up Denny's and then but before we go, I'm gonna have some cherries and I think I'm gonna have some strawberries. Strawberries are super macro friendly, and 2 more scoops of that Nutter Butter. But before I go, I wanna go over how I'm feeling about prep. And honestly, guys, right now, it's almost perfect timing about how shows are closed with my new collection dropping. If you guys see here, I put athlete in quotations and a person who strives to become their best self. And that's really important because with bodybuilding, you can't control what the judges do. You can't control their athletes. You can only control yourself. And I'm in this sport because it's something that I really enjoy. And I feel like you should only do a show if it's something that you want. You shouldn't do it for the clout. You shouldn't do it to impress other people. You should do it for yourself. And this is really important because since the show is canceled, of course, I'm a little disappointed I can't step on stage. But ultimately, I do this at the end of the day for myself. I enjoy the process. I enjoy what I'm doing. And I love pushing my personal limits. So am I upset that I can't step on stage? Yes, but it's okay because I still want to push my limits, see what I can achieve. And I really feel like I definitely brought my best physique after a 2.5 year commitment to a bulk. I'm super happy with what I brought, and I only feel like this delay is going to help me develop a lot more, as I did learn a lot about my body. I learned a lot more about my mindset, and I've been through a lot the last little while. And I feel like these battles with the quarantine, battles with what's going on around the world, only helped me grow.
Luna literally just brought this over to me right now.
So with that said, so guys, I'm gonna be releasing this shirt here in the classic Team Lifts tees, along with these Limitless Collection 2 dad hats, which I'm super happy about. Explain these hats a little bit more. These have meaning as well. I did an LMT with the dash through it because I wanted to make no limit. And I don't know, it goes with the whole Limitless thing. I literally started my first YouTube series and I called it Limitless. So I feel like this collection here does mean a lot, and I'm really excited about this drop here. Literally the best quality stuff that I came out with. And then obviously you guys can't see this through the video, but I used a thicker material with these. Still has that stretch and custom sizing charts. I like to pay attention to the details. And then of course, inside of the hat, I put the Limitless Collection 2, went with the silver buckle. And this is actually a sample. One sec, I'm gonna show you one more detail that I changed. So along with the insert there, I also added another tag. So I'm super excited about these. Definitely the highest quality hat I could find. I'm telling you guys, I went through so many of these. And before we go, show you guys my outfit. I'm wearing an off-white hoodie, athlete joggers with the Yeezys. But I wanted to make these more of a street style look with the hats. So that's why I made them. You can really wear these with anything pretty much. You can wear them in the gym. I wore these pretty much with my street wear. So off-white, Yeezys, that type of thing. So this is like my personal style, and I'm really proud to release this next collection here. So I'm here at Denny's and Hannah wants to make some content. And she's like, you know what? I want to do a crab leg mukbang. So I think she might do that, but I'm just finishing up some work here on the computer.
Hey,
what?
Would you guys watch a crab or a mukbang? Would you guys watch Hannah Ramsey mukbangs? Let us know.
Okay, let us know in the comment section below. But right now, doing up some client work. Been onboarding a bunch of new Team Lifts athletes because of the openings of gyms and closing of gyms. You know, got to adjust with the home workouts as well. That said, I'm gonna edit this video right now, so hopefully it goes up tomorrow. And Hannah is actually reading strength programming. So we did order a whole bunch of new books. I always like to re-up my knowledge, make sure I'm always perfecting my craft, and it's just a lot of fun to read about fitness. Hashtag fitness nerd. I appreciate you guys sticking around, and I am gonna do a giveaway for, I think, 2 to 3 random people. All you have to do is put your email below, and I'm gonna just email 3 random people. So when the collection drops, I'll send you whatever you want, a part of the collection. So other than that, guys, comment, like, subscribe. I appreciate you, and hopefully with this new camera, I'll be seeing you guys soon.